Today I'm going to show you, or teach you, muscle pass. As you see on telly, very rare that not so many people can do it. Basically, it's quite hard. Well, really hard. It's one of the hardest tricks in the chip tricks. To start with, you need a chips. Somehow you want to get that into that hand, but going upwards instead, not going downwards. How do you do that? Well, you've got to establish your technique from the getting that chip to pop up. You see them, you look like, when you see on telly on people showing you, it looks like the chips actually pop up in the middle. Actually, it's not. The chips actually pop up from the side. It's that action. That's what happened, actually. It's that action. It goes out this side first. Not going from the middle or that end. It goes this end. Okay, then, how do we get it to go this end? And how will you get a grip? Getting the grip, it's not that difficult. But the technique of getting the grip is, can use your finger to help you establish which is the best position. Once you get the position right, the position will be, if it's right, it should be not fall out of your hand if you turn it upside down. So that's the grip you want. If you force, then you haven't got the proper grip. So it shouldn't fall. And if you need help, try to push it with one of your fingers or whatever to put it in the right place. If you can, you can also use your left hand to help you to locate the right place and it doesn't drop. Once you get that position right, then you try to squeeze those two parts of your hand so that the chips will somehow go flip over like this. You can do it slowly, just make it flip. See? Once you get that right, then you can go to the next step. Otherwise, not much point. So you're going to get that one hand so the chips just pop up even a little bit, then you have a chance. But if you can't get that actioned, then you have no chance. Okay, once you get that action right, instead of going straight away trying to pop it up, it's not much, won't be the next step. It wouldn't be very good next step anyway, because it's got different problems when you try to pop it up the next hand, because you've got a problem of catching it as well. Which you probably find if you can pop it up, you can't catch it. So next step from that, then you try to pop it up through the hand, but sideways, like so. So you see, it's much easier to catch it if you're going side to side. So that way, you are almost able to catch it. But at the same time, you're learning the pop. See, once you get a pop right, then you can go up. See, up, like so. When you try to go up, if you can do it without moving your hand, it's okay. So, which means you don't get much speed out of it. You might have a short distance if you're good. But if you need help or you want to go up higher, another technique to help that is give that hand a little bit power by giving a bit of push. So you go much higher if you give it a bit of push. But it might not look as good, because people might think you are just throwing the chips. It looks better without moving it, but they won't get so much height. But if you give a bit of push, then let go, you get more height. It looks better. Another thing is, you see most of the graffiti buster does the trick is, they leave the hand open once they've done it. It's good in a way that you're showing the chips are going up. But other way to do it is, try to close your hand at the same time, so just pretending you're holding the chips. Then they're surprised when you open the hand, there's no chips there. So that's another way of presenting the graffiti buster. So you give them a surprise. They say, oh, there should be chips in there, there's none. But at the same time, you've done the muscle pass. Why leave your hand open? So showing them, it's not a trick, or not a magic, or some kind of sort. You just turn them up, pop up. You can do it that way. But alternative, you can do it and crochet hand at the same time, and then you will ask them, how is it possible to tie the hole of chips and throw the chips at the same time? You can't throw a chips and close your fist. So there's no way you can throw a chips and close your fist. So that's an explanation, it's not a throwing chips. I present my muscle pass by closing my hand at the same time. So nobody can do a throw and closing the fist at the same time. Okay, that's how you do the muscle pass. Learn the position of a hand, popping the chips up in the right angle. Then try to pop it on that side. Then pop it up to the other hand. Either with the closing your fist at the same time, or either just pop it up and leave your hand open. Either way, it's up to you. But now I'm going to show you some more different variation of it, which once you can do those, then you can do the one called black hole. What you mean, this is involved holding the chips on your left hand as well, which is another technique. You got to learn to hold the chips on your other hand without dropping the chips. No need help from the other hand, so it looks like it's disappeared. You pop another one up there. You also need to try get your finger to get it so that it stays up there, which is another technique you got to learn. If you're going to do the black hole, then the more you can slot about 7 or 8 in there, but without people seeing it, it's nowhere, it's gone. So, but it's actually there. So that's one I call the black hole. So black hole is involved another technique by holding the chips on your left hand that you have to practice yourself. Then try to catch the chips and holding it there again. So that's that one.
Get your keys, 'cause whatever you're drinking, it's on me, it's on me. Stand if you want to, stare if you want to.